Okay, I'm here at the closing with the circle cutter, so I'm going to use this to cut the perfect hole in the wood. And I had it still set up from the previous jig that I had made, the router fence I had made, but I just wanted to double check that I was absolutely perfect and that I had a really nice friction fit. So here's that's a perfect friction fit. So if I want to use this style, I can use this, but I'm also going to set in T-nuts around here so I can use the flanged piece also. But what you'll notice here is if you look real carefully, and whenever you use one of these things, this is the knuckle buster of all knuckle busters. You just want to keep your hands away from that. But I slipped a little piece of welding wire after I loosened this up. I slipped a little tiny snippet of welding wire up in here. So when I tighten the set screw, it kicked the thing in. So I'm basically making a hole, but I'm also making it a portion of a conic section. So what I'm saying is this is not plumb here. It gets a little bit tighter as it goes down. So it works real well if you have to do that. Otherwise, it's pretty vertical. And but you can see here that as it goes farther in, it gets tighter and tighter. And this is 12 millimeter, and I'm doing this in 18. So by the time it gets down there, it's going to be rock solid and not want to come out. Okay, so let me go ahead and do this. Go nice and slow. Let the cutting tool do the work. So this is a super precision drill press, but it doesn't have the power of that grizzly. Okay, well, you can see how clean that is. I mean, that's just, there's no burning, anything. It's just an incredible way to make custom size holes. You know, I have a 4-inch hole saw, but it's not the right size. It's too sloppy for this. So I tried it. I said, oh, can I just use my hole saw? No, I can't, because it was just too sloppy. So if I was only going to do the flange mount on it, I could have just used the hole saw. But since I want it to have to where I can either use friction or flange, I needed to do it with the circle cutter. Let's see what kind of fit we get here. Ask for a better friction fit than that. It goes in easy, but as it goes farther down, so right when it's flush at the bottom, it's going to be hard pressed to come out of there. But I don't think I'm going to be using it this way that much. But I don't know. I'm still getting used to the router table, so we'll have to see. Okay, that's rolled good enough. Now I'm going to drill my holes through on the other side so I can assemble. I've got to drill these holes first. You know, where I've got these penetrations through here.